Hello everyone. In this video, I will be telling you about XML. Now, what is XML? XML is Extensible Markup Language. Actually, it is a complement of HTML. It is more or less just like HTML, that is Hypertext Markup Language, which I've already discussed in my previous videos. So XML, if I talk about, that is case sensitive, and if I talk about HTML, it is not case sensitive. And what does the word case sensitive means? Case sensitive means, if I write sumi in capital and I write sumi in small, so both sumis would be treated differently. Although the words are same, but they would be treated differently. That is the term case sensitive means. So XML is case sensitive. If I talk about HTML, it is not case sensitive. Then XML stands for Extensible Markup Language, as I told you. It is a markup language much like HTML. It was designed to carry data, not to display data. Yes, it is actually XML is used for carry data from one place to another. Unlike HTML, in which we focuses on the displaying of the data, right? XML is designed to be self-descriptive, and XML is a W3 recommendation. Now, what is W3C? W3C means World Wide Web Consortium recommendations. Then, if I talk about XML uses, then they are, number one, XML separates data from HTML. That means data would be separate and HTML, okay, fine. Second point, XML simplifies data sharing. Yes, as I told you that easily the data can be transferred from one place to another. So it is, they say that the sharing is very much possible in XML. XML simplifies data transport, same thing. XML simplifies platform changes. Even the platform, if it changes, that also it nullifies, it equalizes. XML makes your data more available. And XML is used to create new internet languages. So these are some of the uses of XML as I talk about. If I say XML document form a tree structure. Now I will be telling you the XML document. It would form a tree structure. I show you what is actually a tree. A tree is, it starts from the root and it has branches. Similarly, in XML, you have the root node and then you split every node into branches, it will, and these are also known as, the root is known as a parent and the branches is known as a child. So XML document must contain a root element. The element is the parent of all other elements. The elements in an XML document forms a document tree. So if I talk about in a diagram form, I give you root element. And I give example of bookstore, right? So in this, the branches of the book would be carrying a price also, right? Price of the book. Book would be carrying a name of the author. Book would be carrying the number of pages. So all this thing, if I talk about XML, it has first of all the root node, in which that is split into branches, and they are like price of the book or author or n number of attributes I can have of the book, you know. Then if I talk in a form of XML, how we write it is just like HTML. We use the angular tag like bookstore. If you remember, I said in the starting of the video that we have user-defined tags in this. So this is a user-defined tag, that is bookstore. And I write in the category. In inverted comma, like I can write anything, like if I write a cooking book, okay, fine. Book category, cooking. This way, then I write title. Title language I give, and language I say is English. In short form I write EN, fine. And anything I write here, and then close the title tag, fine. Then author name, I write the author name here and then close the author tag. Then I write the year in which the book was published. Suppose 2005 and I close this year tag also. And then I write the price. Suppose 300 and I close this price tag also. Fine. Then I would book category I created. So I would be closing first the book tag. And at the very end, the bookstore was there. It is just like in HTML, the very first tag which we open is about HTML and the last tag is HTML. So the last tag will be bookstore only. It would be slash bookstore. So this is your XML in which you have user defined tags. If I see in this example, like bookstore is user defined tag. And if I write it in small, and if I write it, suppose I have done like this, in capital B I have written when I am closing it, it would be an error, it won't run. Fine, you will getting an error. So the way it is, if it's in small case, so the closing tag should also be in small case, it should not be capital, any of the word. Fine, so this was all about XML. I hope you understand this XML concept. Thank you and have a nice day. Thank you.